This video tutorial, I will explain what is cross-origin resource sharing and how to enable cross-origin resource sharing. Here you can see rombookstore.com, which exposes web service. And this web service returns a list of books based on the incoming request. Here you can see the website, which is developersitea.com. And here you can see another website, which is developersiteb.com. Both are different origins and different domains. If HTTP requests sent from different origins or different domains using AJAX or JavaScript, then this web service won't return the response back if cross-origin resource sharing is not enabled. Because of security reason, by default, cross-origin requests are not allowed. If the web service need to send response for HTTP request, which is coming from different domains or different origins from JavaScript or AJAX, then we need to enable cross-origin resource sharing, which is nothing but CORS. Suppose say cross-origin request sharing is enabled for this origin, then only this origin can send request to this web service and it can get the response back. If you see these three origins or domains, it looks similar to this allowed origin, but it is not similar. In the first origin, the protocol is different. Here HTTP, here HTTPS. In the second origin, port number is different. Here 8090, here 8080. And the third one, host name is different. And if origin is different, then it will not be allowed. Now we will see how to send HTTP request and reproduce cross-origin issue. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application, and it has a user controller, and it has a method to create the user, update the user, get the user, etc. Now I am going to start this application in 8080 port. This application is started in 8080 port. This is the context path. Here you can see one more Spring Boot demo application. The project name is Spring Boot Demo AJAX. And using this application, we can send requests to this application to create the user. And it has user view controller. It has add user method. When you send requests to this path, it returns this name add hyphen users. And if you see, corresponding HTML is created here. And in this HTML, here I have defined the user model and converting the user model to JSON. Then using post method, using this URL, I am sending the JSON content to this application as a HTTP request. And here you can see application.properties. This application I am going to run in 9090 port. Now I am going to start this application. And this application is started in 9090 port. And here you can see the button. Click here to submit the form. This button, when you click on this, this method will be called and the user create request will go to the Spring Boot demo application. Enable the developer tools. Click on this, and here you can see we got a cross origin issue. Here you can see the error message. The error message says access to XML HTTP request at this URL from this origin has been blocked by CORS policy. And click on network, and here also you can see CORS error. Click on this. This is the request URL, and this is the payload, and we didn't get any response. Next, we will see how to solve this CORS issue. Now we will see how to enable a cross-origin request in REST controller. Here you can see web security class. In that configure method, we have to enable CORS. http.CORS. Save these changes. Then go to user controller. Here you can see user controller class, which is a REST controller, and it has a create user method. In this method, I have applied a cross origin annotation, and origins I have specified star. Star meaning from any origins or any domains, HTTP requests are allowed. And this method will process the request and send the response back. We will run this application and see whether it is working or not. And if you see users table, there is no users are there. Click on this button, and we got alert, and if you see, there is no CORS issue. And here you can see, one record is created. Here I have specified origins as star, meaning any origin. And if I want to specify only particular origin, then I have to do like this. In the origins, I have to specify only one origin, like this. So from only this origin, the request is allowed, and this method will process the request and send the response back. The first one I have commented out, and the second one I have enabled. Now we will start the application, see whether it is working or not. Delete this record. Click on this. And you can see there is no CORS issue. And user is successfully created. And if you want to specify multiple origins, then what we can do is, we can specify the origins with comma separated, like this. So in this, origins end with 9090 port and 9091 port are allowed. We will run this application and see whether it is working or not. And if you see, there is no CORS issue, and record is successfully created. Here we have allowed cross origin for only create user method. And if you see, there are a lot of other methods also there in user controller class. Suppose you want to apply cross origin for all the other methods in this user controller, then what we have to do is copy this and apply in class level. And comment this. Save these changes. Now we will run this application and see whether it is working or not. And if you see, there is no CORS issue. And user record is successfully created. Now we will see global CORS configuration. Suppose say we have a web service application. It has a user controller, login controller, and order controller. And all this controller, we want to enable CORS configuration in one common place. Then what we can do is, we can use the concept called global CORS configuration. We will see how to do that. In user controller class, I have enabled cross origin annotation. Comment this one. And here I have defined the class webconfig, which implements web MVC configurer and override add CORS mapping method. And this method accept registry. And in this class, I have applied configuration annotation. Here I am calling add mapping method of registry. And here we have to specify path pattern, basically mapping URI. And for this URI, CORS will be enabled. Then I am calling allowed methods and passing HTTP methods. For these methods, CORS will be enabled. And here I am passing post and get. Then I am calling allowed origins. And here we have to specify what and all origins CORS should be enabled. Now I am going to start this application. Delete this, click on this, and we got alert message, and we didn't get CORS issue. Refresh, and one user record is created. Suppose I want to enable CORS for all the mapping, all the methods, and all the origins, then I have to do like this. All the mappings means slash star star, and all the methods means star, and all the origins means star. Now I am starting this application. We got alert message and we did not get CORS issue. And here you can see one user record is created. Now we will see how to enable CORS in Spring Security configuration. Suppose we have a web service application. It has three controllers. And all these three controllers, I want to enable CORS. We will see how to do that. First, comment this global configuration. Here you can see web security class and which extends web security configurer adapter. And in this class, enable web security annotation is applied. And in configure method, http.cors. Dot and we have to add that we have already seen. If a bean name CORS filter is provided, then that will be used. Or CORS configuration source is provided, then that will be used. we will define the bean CORS configuration source. Here I have defined the method CORS configuration source, which returns CORS configuration source bean. Here I have applied bean annotation, and here I am creating a CORS configuration object. Then I am setting allowed origin as star, meaning all the origins are allowed, and set allowed methods are star, meaning all HTTP methods are allowed, and allowed headers I have applied star, meaning all HTTP headers are allowed, and allowed credential I have set it as true. So this is for whether user credentials are supported or not, and I have set it as true. Here I have created a URL based CORS configuration source object, and then I am calling register CORS configuration method and passing the path pattern and the configuration, and it returns the source object. Now I am going to start this application. Click on this, and we got alert message, and we did not get CORS issue. And here you can see one user record is created. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.